Og helgen nærmer seg, spør alle hva jeg gjør da Jeg hitter kløben som om hverdag var en lørdag
Today is Wednesday and today I am starting lesson number 3, Bravo Manju Now first of all I am going to give you the hard words of this lesson Let's start Now look, all the children will be attentive and they should look at the blackboard what I am teaching here So be attentive children The first word is material, nervous, pressed, wearily, pressed, steady, price, trunk, defend, jumped. Now these are the 10 difficult words or hard words we can say and you have to search the meaning of these hard words and write in your notebook. Before going into the explanation, I will give a short story of this lesson. The Manju, by the name Manju, you can say it is the name of a girl. And Bravo means we have been bucking up, we have been praising this girl. Now this Manju, she is a disabled child. And she is having two fingers on each of hand. All of us are having five fingers. But this girl, as she is a disabled child, disabled means physically unfit. And disabled child, so she is facing a number of problems in her life. And how she get out from these problems, we will look in this lesson. So children, get ready with your English reader. I am going into the explanation, so be ready. And be attentive in class while I am explaining the lesson. Okay, children. Now children, already we have done revision of two lessons, lesson number 1 and 2. Now this is lesson number 3. Now we have to start from lesson number 3, Bravo Manju. Manjula was born with two fingers on each hand, but that does not stop her from pursuing her interest. Does she overcome the hurdles and take up the challenges or give up? Read this inspiring story. Now this is the story of Bravo Manju, and she was a disabled child, and she is having two fingers on each hand. Now each of us are having five fingers. Now she is a disabled child, so she is having only two fingers on each hand, but this disability had not stopped her from moving further, and there came a lot of challenges in her life, but she doesn't give up. And this is an inspiring story, and let us study further what happened next. Manjula Palkar knew she would never paint like Hussain, not with those fingers, just two or each hand. Handling brushes was no problem. Her problem was the cost of the material she would need. Now here Manjula, she is not like a painter like Hussain, but she is interested in painting. But the problem is not with her hand, but the problem is with the material buying. Means with financially she was weak, and she was weak, and as the problem was that how she will ask her parents to buy her the material of painting. Mummy, she asked one evening while helping her mother in the kitchen after dinner, do you think I could? She paused nervously. I could have some extra money tomorrow. Now having collecting a strength, she went to her mother asking that, mother, could I have some money, extra money to buy the what? To buy the material of painting. What do you need it for? Asked her mother, gently rinsing the dishes. Now as she was washing utensils, her mother asked her that, for what you want the money? For colors and paint. I want to learn painting. Mrs. Palkar looked at her daughter searchingly. After some time, she pressed some money into Manjula's hand. Go ahead and buy whatever you need, dear. Have fun and show me the
painting. Now her mother was very happy and she was surprisingly looking her daughter that how she is so interested in painting, and she was at the same time she was also very surprised, and she gave her daughter some money in her hand and asked her to go further and buy the colors and have fun and enjoy painting, and after making the painting show it to me. Manjula showed her first painting to her mother the very next day. Manjula cried her mother dropping her needlework in surprise. "Why, that is beautiful. I didn't know you were so good. You must have shown it to Papa. He will be impressed." Now Manjula went into the market, buy the colors and all the material, and then she came back and started painting the picture. And after some the next day, within one day only, she had painted a beautiful picture, and she came with that picture to show it to her mother. Now her mother was busy doing the needlework sitting in the room, and as she saw Manjula coming, she told mother, "I have made a painting." And after listening to this, she became very surprised, and she dropped her needlework and saw the painting, and she was surprised to see the picture. "What beautiful," she told, and she told her to go and show it to her father. She will be impressive. Manjula returned to her brushes and paints. Nobody had asked Manjula what she wanted for her 13th birthday, yet she got all she had secretly wished for.